drilling holes in stainless steel tube. Step one, Bosch bimetal sheet hole saw, 25 mil. Good quality 3 or 3.5 millimeter drill bit, a good quality 6 millimeter drill bit, and 6 mil Bosch power change adapter. First step, pilot hole. Let the drill bit do the cutting. Second step, 6 millimeter hole. The key part here is speed. If you drill too fast, the drill bit heats up, the stainless work hardens, and the drill bit won't last as long. The reason I go through with the 6 first and not the power change bit is purely because these are twice the price of a good Dorma drill bit. The longer I can make this bit last, the better. The cutting speed here is super important, as is the position of the drill. Because this is a nice straight piece of tube, I can just go in at a nice 45 degree angle. It's comfortable for me to hold. And I don't need to worry about the drill bit snagging. So you might get a little bit of the way in with the drill bit and it'll snag. And if you're holding it too tightly, if you've got your piece in a vise, or if you're trying to do this in a pillar drill, all you will do is you'll snap the teeth off the hole saw. You know, it's good to have a little bit of give in what you're cutting. And if everything's fixed solid, you don't have that and the drill bit just won't last as long. As you can see, I've started to cut through here and I've gone all the way through. This is one of the most crucial bits because this is where your teeth will start to snag in that hole. I now need to put more cutting effort on the rest of the tube that I haven't yet begun to cut. That is how I'm gonna make the teeth last longer, because I'm gonna let the teeth ride on the tube rather than getting snagged in that hole. So there we go, we've cut through, and it really is so important that you let the teeth do the cutting and you're not forcing the hole saw into the tube. I know it sounds obvious to let the drill do the cutting, but it is really easy to get carried away and force it in. And the same with the speed. You don't need loads of speed. This drill's got 2 speeds. I'm actually using the higher speed, but a minimal trigger position. If I use the lower speed, what that gives me is more torque. More torque means more chance of ripping a tooth off as I slide into the cut, basically. And I don't want to do that. So I want low speed and low torque. The other aspect is, if you've got several holes to do, what you'll find is that the drill bit will heat up with each hole you do. This is where you need several drill bits, because you cycle them to keep the temperature down, but not slow you down. So if you've got 20 holes to drill in 20 downpipes, use the first hole saw 2 times, then go to your second hole saw 2 times, and then your third hole saw 2 times, and then back to your first one again. That way you can keep the heat down, and that all adds up to make the hole saw last longer. And when you talk about trying to make more money, one of the easiest ways is to make your tools last longer. The more holes you can get out of one hole saw, the better it is. Hope this helps. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments.